A piston cylinder device contains 1.8 kilograms of nitrogen, initially at 90 kilopascals and 20 degrees Celsius. The nitrogen is now compressed slowly in a polytropic process with a polytropic index of 1.3 until the volume is reduced to 1/3. Determine the work done and the heat transfer for this process. As usual, try solving this problem yourself before watching the solution. This is the second example for the Polytropic Processes main lecture video. The links to that 10-minute video, the other examples for this topic, and the other lectures of the Thermodynamics course are found in the description below. Using the expression we derived in the main lecture video, we see that we need the volumes and P2. The pressure at 2 can be easily found because if we know that PV to the 1.3 is constant, we can solve for P2 and use the ratio between V1 and V2, knowing that the volume was reduced to 1/3, to substitute all values and find that P2 is 375 kilopascals. V1 can be found using the ideal gas equation. We look up the gas constant for nitrogen and substitute all values to find that V1 is 1.739 cubic meters. And since the volume was reduced to 1/3, V2 is equal to 1/3 of this number. We can now substitute the values in the work expression we derived in the main lecture and find that the work is -204 kilojoules. This negative sign is consistent with our convention since we needed to add work to the system to compress it. As for the heat, since Q minus W is delta U, Q is equal to W plus delta U. The change in internal energy is mCv delta T, and yes, that is the specific heat at constant volume. Remember that we can use either specific heat depending on what we're looking for, not necessarily because of the type of process or system we have. In this case, we're only missing the change in internal energy change, and that, by definition, uses Cv. We look up the specific heat Cv at around 350 Kelvin, and this is a good approximation since we start just below 300 and we're gaining temperature as we compress the piston cylinder, and we calculate T2 with the ideal gas equation. We substitute all values that we had already found to calculate the total heat transfer as -50.5 kilojoules. And again, this is consistent. A negative heat means that heat is coming out of the system, which makes sense. If you want to watch some of the other examples on this topic or the other lectures of the thermo course or the other engineering courses, make sure to check out the links in the description below. Thanks for watching.